my judge. Judge time. Ready?
It's one championship. Ready? Iron Will, Dagi and Yamada.
I said that Yamada has 13 first round finishes, but Dagi has never been past the 2 minute mark. So you can expect very fast paced action in this one.
Dagi's coach Burak says it will be difficult for Yamada. I actually got the feeling they felt a little sorry for Yamada, anticipating the damage they were going to do to the Japanese athlete tonight. Dagi is renowned for his aggression. Yamada, though, a very unorthodox opponent. You can already see the jittery style of the MMA fantasista. Dagi catches a roundhouse kick. Yamada on his back. Dagi sticks him with a right hand. Slings the legs a little now. Does the Turk. And allows Yamada back to his feet, Mitch.
I've been speaking to Burak all week, and he says that he's been trying to control Dagi. Slow him down. Have him show some patience in there and some calmness and not rush in. Looks like he clipped him there with the left hook. Yamada was okay to drop down. I think it was more of a tactic rather to draw Dagi down into his guard.
That was a sweetly timed little popping left hook that caught Yamada. Yamada goes to the inside leg. He's got to be careful of spinning around after those techniques, because Dagi will pounce on him if given half a chance. Again, you see the spin around there after the failed kick from Yamada. Easy for Dagi to time a counter. Spin around from Dagi.
Yamada's got to be careful. You can see the hands are constantly changing, always moving around. A nice takedown, reversal by Dagi.
And ground and pound chance now for Dagi. What's Yamada hunting for here, Drew?
Yamada's looking for a heel hook. He's trying to attack that leg. He's got that singles Z guard there. Single X guard, rather. But beautifully done by Dagi to get away. Now he's back on top.
You can hear the shrieks of excitement in the crowd here in Bangkok. They are loving every moment of this martial arts battle between Japan and Turkey. Now it's Dagi inside the closed guard of Tetsuya Yamada. Posture's up.
Posture up, trying to drop some of that ground and pound, but nice evasion there from Yamada.
Dagi's gone more than 2 minutes now, almost 2.5 minutes for the turn. Yamada back to his feet. He's been around for a long time, Yamada. He's seen it all in southpaw stance here. Dagi on the outside. Tries to stick him with the left hand. Close guard off his back here from Yamada. Yamada's Dagi break it open and drop the heavy hands and elbows, Mitch.
Yamada spent a lot of time at Tiger Muay Thai out there at Phuket, Thailand, working with a lot of high-level wrestlers who do this type of style, the exact style that Dagi does. They like to get on top and like to drop bombs. So Yamada says he's very comfortable. Look at that spinning for an armbar. Dagi picking him up, completely muscling him up, and just slides the arm out. Beautifully done.
Yamada, the very awkward, jittery start. He skips forward again, throws a high left round. Dagi catches it, gets a takedown, does the Turk. Gives him a taste of the left hand of the orbital. Single leg here from Yamada. Can he affect another takedown?
Kimura grip there from Dagi, uses it to roll. Yamada back on top, though.
We said this would be a first round of all-out aggression, and has certainly been that, Mitch.
Lots of back-and-forth action, lots of high-level technique shown by both these guys, but beautiful just transitions. I like the way Yamada is mixing in his grappling with his takedowns. He's transitioning beautifully.
Is Dagi going to get taken into the second round? Unfamiliar territory for the Turk.
There's all sorts of people not used to seeing Dagi on his back. Beautiful reserve. Just as I say that, he reverses.
And the first strikes, and now strikes. He's got the back end. Yamada standing. What's he going to do with the Japanese athlete?
Looks like he's taking him for a ride. Beautifully. Looks like Yamada's got a little bit of a cut on the top of his head from some of that ground and pound earlier by Dagi.
Is Dagi going to measure him here? He swings the legs a little. Will he allow Yamada back to his feet? And Olivier Coles does that for him. 30 seconds remain in what's been a completely entertaining first round. Oh, beautiful counter down the tube as Yamada went for the roundhouse kick. That was timing from Dagi. Inside leg hit, Dagi caught him again. With timing like that, he should be switched. cross, not turn.
He's just timing that low kick so beautifully. Immediately as Yamada goes in, he's trying to throw the kick. Dagi's sliding through and landing some punches. That was a beautiful duck under right there to end the round. Here's Dagi catching the kick, sweeping the leg, getting on top, and just throwing. That's where he's most impressive. Once he gets on top and starts letting those punches go. Look at that, beautifully saw it coming in. Look at this reverse. Watch this, boom, beautifully done by Yamada. Bang, look at that, right on top, just hips. His hips are so fluid. Once he gets on top of you, he just starts letting them come down. Goes knee on belly, starts dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Very impressive first round from both these guys. Slight edge, gotta go to Dagi.
Mitch, you said this one could be the show stealer of the night, and certainly that opening round was off the charts for entertainment.
Yeah, these two are putting on a show here in Bangkok. They both realize what's at stake for both these guys, and they're trying to push the action.
We're ready to roll, second round, set for three from the Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand. It's the largest martial arts organization in the world. It's one championship, Iron Will. Wherever you're watching in 146 countries
back.
Around the world, potentially over 1.7 billion views. Hope you're enjoying it just as much as we are. And now, Dagi finds himself in the second round for the first time in his career. Unfamiliar territory for the Turk. A little popping uppercut there off the right hand. Yamada with the high kick.
See Yamada maybe set up some of these kicks with some punches because Dagi's just waiting. He's waiting to time it just like that. As Yamada's throwing a kick, he's throwing punches. He immediately sees that. I'd like to see Yamada start putting punches together and then throw the kick.
Yamada clinching up with Dagi. Dagi turns him around. Takedown there from the Turk. Nicely done. Half guard position. Can he get some ground and pound? Can he posture up?
Some beautiful hips by Dagi. The way he senses the technique as Yamada's applying a lot of the pressure and coming forward, Dagi just momentarily floats over the first position.
Another attempt there from Yamada to no avail. Is Dagi going to let him back to his feet? And yes, he is. He wants to get those strikes off. Yamada look for that high left roundhouse kick. Goes down the center with a left cross out of southpaw stance. Dagi's got his back now. Kimura attempt from Yamada. Spin around Kimura. Sakuraba style. Couldn't get it.
Did you see the way Dagi cut the angle there? As Yamada threw the left hand, Dagi stepped off to the side and hit with an uppercut of his own. Beautifully done.
Shades of Sakuraba versus Henzo Gracie there from Tetsuya Yamada.
That's a scary ball.
From Dagi. There's the roundhouse kick to the ribs, and Dagi throws him to the canvas. Strength in the Turk is frightening. And Yamada back to his feet again.
Yamada's got to stop throwing these single kicks. Look at that. He throws the kick, Dagi catches it, lands the strike, or he catches it, throws him on the ground, right there's a big shot of his arm.
Is Yamada beginning to tire out here?
I think he's starting to fatigue. I think he's starting to wane just a little bit. But he's got to mix up these kicks. He's got to put some punches together with these kicks. You can see the hands on the knees.
Oh, the high kick. Dagi went for the headache maker. Okay. Tetsuya Yamada continually having to pick himself up off the canvas. Dagi will not go down and engage with him. He tries for an Aoki style. Low double leg takedown. Dagi with the jab. The Turk in control. This crowd in Bangkok not liking the style of Yamada, who wants it on the ground.
But every time Yamada has to get up off the ground, that is draining him. Look at him with his hands on his knees, big heavy press.
Draining him physically and mentally.
Exactly. It's so demoralizing just to have your opponent ragged on you. But Yamada's continuing to attack. Now he's almost got the back. He's in a dominant position. Yeah, Dagi's able to shrimp out in the half guard.
Most dominant position Yamada's been in so far tonight. Can he make the most of it? Can he capitalize?
If Dagi's able to get up out of this and not take any damage, it's going to demoralize Yamada.
Go holding what?
Go holding close guard what? From the Turk. Controlling the posture of Yamada. And Yamada broke open that guard, tried for some submission attempts, posture up and land some ground and pound. Let the Turk know that he's here.
This is where he's wanted to get the match the entire second round. Let's see if he can do anything with it. Dagi's defending well, keeping his head pulled down low, so Yamada can't really put any power into these shots. Those are just kind of soft, pitter-pat shots, not really doing a lot of damage.
Dagi, who began his martial arts training as a young boy in Wushu, now renowned, of course, for his Muay Thai and his BJJ.
That first round was so fast-paced and furious, Michael, that we're starting to see the effects of it. The stamina is starting to slowly drain out of both these guys, not just Yamada. Dagi's breathing heavy, too, especially in this position. Dagi would normally explode out of this position and just burst on him, but he can't do that. He's also fatigued. Both these guys are putting it all out there.
Dagi, a BJJ brown belt, IBJJF European Open silver medalist and no gi silver medalist. He knows what it's like on the ground. He knows how to finish on the ground. Closes the guard again. 15 seconds on the clock. Second round of three. Some better signs in this round, Mick, from Tetsuya Yamada.
Yeah, he was looking like he was fading there, Michael. You saw him look over at his corner and almost in desperation. But to come back and to finish the round on top in a dominant position, landing the ground and pound, says a lot about the warrior spirit in Yamada.
Yamada certainly found his second win. And can he continue the momentum in the third and final?
That's how Dagi was doing. He was landing uppercuts from awkward angles, hitting it from big shots. There was the Kimura attempt, and that was beautifully done. Look at it, catch the kick, posts off the head, sweeps the leg over and over again, making Yamada miss his strike, and then throwing him onto the ground, and then forcing him to get back up to his feet. That's been what sucked the energy out of Yamada.
What tactics do you see here from Dagi?
You know, we're seeing just really a lot of control. He's used to blitzing on his opponents and just overwhelming them. But Yamada didn't break. He was right in there. So you gotta wonder, are some of these, you know, things that Yamada's doing in there, are they tactics from the veteran? Is it things that he's learned, which is not quantifiable? It's experience. He knows what he needs to do to break Dagi. Is he doing that now?
Three of Dagi's four wins have been by TKO.
Ready?
Punches. Could he be buying? Could he have a crack at a Go Daddy knockout of the night contender? We'll see how he goes here in the third and final. This crowd is booing Yamada. They want to see him back to his feet, but we are seeing an intriguing battle of martial arts styles here. One in which Dagi will not engage on the ground with Yamada unless he needs to.
And he's doing just that. He's waiting for the low kick, catching the low kick, sweeping to over and over. And then he's gonna make Yamada get back up.
And as you said, Mitch, this is constantly demoralizing Yamada. And the crowd knows that because the crowd's here in Thailand used to seeing the dumps in Muay Thai where combatants have to continually put themselves up.
And that is a huge factor in Muay Thai. You see the crowd ooh and ah every time it happens because they know what it's like to be controlled like that. It just shows more domination.
And you see when Dagi does catch the kicking leg of Yamada, he is executing those Muay Thai dumps. And the crowd loving him, swinging the legs here, listen to them every time he lands. That is fantastic, isn't it, Mitch? They are loving it here in Bangkok, as are we. It's ONE Championship, the largest martial arts organization in the world.
That was a little bit better. Yamada ducked under. He was waiting for Dagi to punch him. That's just strength right there. Control off the wizard, the head and arm control. Beautifully done by Dagi, just to muscle Yamada onto the ground.
This is Dagi in control. This is one-way traffic driving its way to Istanbul.
Ooh, that was an up kick. It looked like he possibly had multiple points down. So it could have been an illegal upkick. Olivier Cost is assessing the situation, seeing what's going on here. Let's take a look at it right now. See, yeah, all the knees and feet were down. That's 4 points. Boom, right there, head kick. Right on the chin. Yamada realizes what he did wrong.
again in our global rule set. You cannot kick to the head of a grounded opponent, Mitch, including that fashion.
You gotta have 3 points. He had four down, two knees and the feet. That's gonna be an illegal up kick. Dagi seems to be a little bit rocked by that shot. Let's see if the match is gonna continue. Doggy's actually calling for Coach Burak to maybe translate what's going on. This is good for Yamada, though. This is allowing Yamada some time to breathe, some time to get that juice back. I believe the doctor's gonna go in and check that little cut above the eye of Yamada.
It's only good if he doesn't get disqualified.
That's a very good point, Michael. Look at that, right in the face. Immediately, both of them knew what they did, what happened, and where things went wrong. Yamada's getting checked out by the doc. Doggy's getting checked out by the corner.
We should say there was nothing really intentional there from Yamada. He's a fantastic sportsman, has that Budo spirit, but he made a mistake.
Exactly. Budo being the martial arts spirit for all you folks out there that might not speak the dialect of the martial arts encyclopedia, Michael Chiavello.
It looks like we're okay to go on. So, no intentional technique there from Yamada. It was just something in the spirit of the moment. The adrenaline flowing as it must in the biggest stage of all martial arts. One championship. Still inside the third and final round. And another beautifully timed straight left jab there from Dagi. He's been timing that all night, Mitch.
You can see him just getting better and better at the time. You can see him, even before the kick was thrown, right before that hip started to twitch, he immediately went in, caught the kick, and put a fake hand right in the face of Yamada.
And again, Dagi. Yamada is the veteran here, but it doesn't look like he has the tricks up his sleeve against Dagi tonight. Listen to this crowd again. Costa's gonna let Yamada choke back to his feet and save that slinging any more punishment. It's time for Yamada to put the foot down, Mitch, to throw caution to the wind. It's been a windy week in Bangkok, so there's a lot of caution to throw. Single leg from Yamada. Dagi ends up in mount. He's gonna take his back.
He tried to defend. He tried to defend the shot. Look at this roll, look at this transition. Here's an arm. Yamada's got to defend the arm lock. He's going belly down. That's it.
Dagi is back in the winner's circle. And the crowd are loving it. A belly down armbar from the turn.
Beautifully done. Did you see the way he attacked that arm with lightning fast precision? Yamada was transitioning, Yamada was rolling, trying to stay advantage. Look at this, he has the Kimura grip. Dagi throws the legs up over the head, flattens out. Beautifully done armbar finish. Dagi is back. Beautifully done. What a way, after a year-long layoff, he comes back, faces a high-level, world-class opponent for a huge victory.
A very popular victory. A very popular martial arts stylist is the Turk, Dagi. Great sportsmanship. Both men giving each other a hug. And Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 51 seconds in the third round. For your winner, by way of armbar, Saygid Guseyn Arslanaliev!
A massive ovation in Bangkok for Saygid Guseyn Arslanaliev, more commonly known to the martial arts world as Dagi. Back in the winner's circle with a magnificent belly down armbar.
Judge, time, ready.
Inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium, and Christian Lee in the white trunks bounds out of his corner. A cutting side kick early to the lead knee. We're back under our global rule set, mixed martial arts. Quick hand from Christian Lee, gets a takedown.
Nice entry into that takedown. Hit that straight right hand right into a double leg. But look at the judo black belt getting thrown on his butt right there.
Ultra aggressive start here from young Christian Lee. 9 wins, 5 KOs, 4 submissions, 100% finishing rate.
Interesting clinch battle we got going on here. Boom! Puts him down.
Nicely done there from Top of the Doorman. The lightweight king of Pancrase. 19 wins, 9 knockouts, 2 submissions. Second degree black belt in judo, BJJ purple belt. Holds a degree in judo therapy from the Nippon Engineering College of Hachioji.
He's got that defensive guard right there. Now Tokudome tried to step over. Now he's in the half guard. Christian Lee tapping the back of the head there. That's not legal. Tokudome does a good job of pressing him up against the cage. Christian Lee's going to try to walk out and create a little space off of that cage.
Tokudome predicted he'd knock out Christian Lee with punches. Lee said, I'll submit him in the very first round. Back to their feet here. Singaporean crowd right behind Christian Lee. In his corner, his father Ken Lee, his sister, Atomweight World Champion, undefeated, unstoppable Angela Lee. Nice corking outside thigh knees there from Top of Gorman.
I know Martin Nguyen is paying very close attention to this one. He's in the crowd sitting front row right there. He's got his eye on both these two as possible competitors. He's gone up against Christian Lee before, and a rematch has been in the works. If Christian Lee can get past Tokudome on this one.
Side kick there from Lee. BJJ black belt, 8-week training camp. Said he refined every piece of his game, tightened up everything, says he's faster and has the advantage everywhere. Hartlett's roundhouse kick from Washington. Oh, no hand! Smack bang on the kisser from Christian Lee.
Right into the entry, into the double leg. Tokudome's got to be careful that trip right there. Good defense. Give up his back. Good scramble from Tokudome.
Tokudome said his strategy is to keep the match standing for as long as he can. Though he did expect Christian Lee to try and take him down. Southpaw stance here for Tokudome. There's that one. Smack back again to the kisser. And the Hannibal strike from Christian Lee. The aggression now from the youngster. The reverse elbows from Lee. And he's in full mount now. Tokudome gives his back. The hooks go in. And trouble for the Japanese. Christian Lee. A house on fire. Tokudome.
After 3 minutes and 7 seconds in the first round, for your winner by way of technical knockout, Christian Lee!
Another highlight reel finish from 20-year-old Christian Lee. The warrior, indeed, an ignite. He brought the aggression early. He never relented until the job was done.